morning. Welcome to the Land Use Committee, Land Use Public Hearing at Queensborough Hall. If you wish to testify on any items, please fill in a speaking request for each item. Indicate on the form the calendar number whether you're for or against the item, and if you're speaking as a representative of any group. The applicant will be called to give a description of zoning action requested, an explanation of the proposed project, and respond to any questions from the chair. The floor will then be open to public speakers. Each speaker will have 3 minutes. At the discretion of the chair, if there's a large number of speakers on any particular item, they may be put on a second call. I don't think that'll be a problem. So thank you for your cooperation and for joining us today. First item.
Calendar item number one, VSA number 112964BZ. The applicant, David Off Crusher and Citron LLP, affected community board number 13.
Good morning, Maura Martins from David Off Crusher and Citron LLP on behalf of the applicant and owner. This is an application on the...
One second. Can you work in? Mm-hmm. I apologize. Go ahead.
It's an application on the Board of Standards and Appeals Special Order Calendar for an extension of term to extend the term of a variance for an additional 10 years to allow continued operation of an auto parts sale establishment at 14736 Brookville Boulevard and Rose Balcane, Community Board 13. The application also seeks an addition to the extension of the term, an amendment to the board resolution to permit to legalize some interior layout changes to the building, to eliminate the term of years, and to allow additional use group 6 use rather than the specific auto parts sales use group 6 use that's been permitted in the board's resolution. The board originally granted the variance, but they also seek a waiver of the board's rules as the application was filed a few months after the term of the variance expired last June.
What? So the community board voted, I'm having trouble finding it, I apologize. What was the vote?
It was approved.
What was the vote?
In favor. So unanimous in favor.
Yes, but they had conditions, right? And so what were those conditions?
Yeah. That's
what we can't find.
They actually, the copy of their recommendation that I received did not have any conditions.
So it's approved with modifications or conditions, and that's what I'm saying.
Right, that's the only document I got. The only thing that was discussed in their motion was just to approve the application. The only thing that was discussed was that they did not want to eliminate the term.
Okay. Did they suggest a term to do it?
They seem to be okay with the 10-year term.
And your application is still to eliminate the term?
Yes. The variance was originally granted in 1965. The auto parts store has been there since before them. The variance was actually to enlarge the non-conforming use. So it's been operating for about 50 years. It's a small family-owned business, and seeking a renewal of the variance every 10 years is an economic hardship on the applicant. The area is an R32 zoning district. However, there is a C2 overlay across the street. There's an associated supermarket, a pharmacy, and other commercial uses in the area. And that's the justification for requesting that amendment to the board's resolution.
I assume your two ECB violations would be true.
Yes. Okay. I also took it.
You were trying to say something. Yeah, no, I understood that. I just didn't know where they stood. Anything else? Thank you. Appreciate it. Anybody here to testify? Mm-hmm. Great. Now the issue's closed. Thank you.
Calendar item number two, VSA number 1792BZ, the applicant Eric Palatnik, BC, affected community board number two.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Michael Dacunas from Eric Palatnik, BC. The zoning action is for to renew the term of a variance which expired on 7/19/2014 for a Taco Bell that's on Northern Boulevard between 60 and 61st Street. And it has a drive-through, so we're asking for a waiver of the board rules because the term expired and to extend the term to 2024. We're also asking for amendments to repair the roof and change the signage and rearrange the seating and upgrade the tabletops. But otherwise, there's no changes to the building itself. We were unanimously approved by the community board with conditions, Those conditions were based on a stipulation we signed with the local civic association, which I assume is incorporated in the community board's recommendation. We intend to fully comply with all those stipulations.
How many people work there?
About 40.
How many people work there?
40.
40? At Taco Bell?
Yeah.
Oh, can you, I hate to say this, but it's sort of not the Socratic method here. You have to come up and identify yourself.
Sorry, I didn't know.
No, it's all right, thank you.
But, how are you?
My name is Greg Lyne. I'm the vice president of operations at CPA Management. We operate the Taco Bell.
Okay. How many people work there?
About 40.
And the hours are?
Operating hours are 7 a.m. to 1 a.m.
But no, it should be 8 a.m. to 1 a.m.
Okay, and it looks like you've negotiated with the community board all the issues that they care about. Civic group, right, but the community board is using that as their agreement as well.
Yes.
It looks like you need to ask DOT for something?
It's a request. Maybe you could help us with that, just to know what turns up.
Good idea. So, what is it?
Just the, when people come out of the lot, no left turn sign onto Northern Boulevard, which people shouldn't do anyway, but.
Okay, have you contacted DOT about that yet, or are we waiting until all this passes?
We're waiting at this point, but it's a request that we agreed that we would make.
Any questions? Appreciate it, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Anybody have a testimony? The item is closed, thank you.
Calendar item number three, BSA number 20162019BZ. The applicant, Taco Bell PC, effective community board number 5.
Good morning.
Nice seeing you.
I'm Amanda, I'm the Taco Bell PC on behalf of the applicant, owner of the lot. This is a variance application for standards and appeals to permit the development of a two-story plus cellar mixed-use building with ground floor partial use and residential use on the second floor. The waivers we're requesting are residential floor area, front yard, side yard use, and car parks. It's a vacant, regularly shaped corner lot with approximately 35 feet of frontage on 74th Street and 102 feet of frontage on Borough Avenue. The lot area is about 2,620 square feet. The lot narrows from the width of 35 feet on 74th Street to approximately 22 feet on the western lot line. There's also a portion of Myrtle Avenue that is mapped to be widened, so this is also seeking a GCL Section 35 waiver to build in the bed of that street. So again, this is a two-story plus cellar mixed-use building. Total floor area is 4,232 square feet with a 1.62 FAR. Ground floor commercial use and two-bedroom dwelling units on the second floor. To the waivers, the residential floor area waiver is seeking a waiver of zoning resolution section 23-141. The maximum permitted residential floor area is 1,965 square feet at a 0.75 FAR. We're proposing 2,116 square feet with a 0.81 FAR. The front yard waiver is because a 10-foot front yard is required, and we are proposing no front yard. The side yard waiver is because 2 8-foot side yards are required. We are proposing no side yard along the westerly lot line and a 5-foot side yard along the northerly lot line. The parking waiver is because 2 parking spaces are required, and we are proposing 0 parking spaces. And the use waiver is for the ground floor commercial use, as this is within an R4 zoning district. We went to the community board, and it was approved on condition of 3 street trees along Myrtle Avenue and 1 street tree along 74th Street. The GCL 35 portion of the application was also sent out to DOT and FDNY, and DOT is okay with it with a few conditions. They want some revisions to the plans and clarification. FDNY is fine with the project as long as a fire hydrant is located within 250 square feet. There's actually one right in front of the premises on 74th Street, and this is what FDNY.
you know why the one person voted against it, the community board?
I guess they didn't vocalize why, there was just a no.
Who's Vinnie?
Yes.
The chair?
Yeah, the chair.
And he voted against it, why?
Because they
Further voted. So what do we say to that? That the self-created hardship, something that we might have known fully what?
Well, it's inherent in the lot. The owner did not create the irregular condition of the lot. And if he chose not to buy it, it would be vacant for a number of years. But you see, to redevelop a vacant lot, it's been vacant for over 60 years. He did not create the condition of the shape and size of the lot.
I understand this. All right, anything else? Anybody here to testify? No?
You're not having a front yard, so how does that line up with the building on the block?
It actually lines up. Everything is pretty much built to the front lot line along Myrtle Avenue. The building was front Myrtle Avenue, not 74th Street. Everything is pretty much built lot line and to the front yard. And the side yard waiver is consistent with the buildings fronting Myrtle that are lot line to lot line. In addition, may I mention that the blocks to either side of us have a commercial overlay, except for this one block. And there's actually a commercial office on the lot right next to it.
When did you find by this property? About?
I would have to look back and get back to you on that.
A year ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago?
More than a year ago.
More than a year ago, less than 10.
I was there.
I assume that it was bought with the price in mind that I would complete a regular lot. What do you have to pay for the BSA during this application? Okay. Thank you. Good? The item is closed. Next item.
Calendar item number 4, ruler number C160070ZNQ. The applicant Ackerman LLP, affected community board number 13.
Good morning. Lisa Orantia from Ackerman LLP. We represent Title Watts LLC in this application for zoning map amendment that will impose a commercial overlay and underlying residential district. This is to facilitate the development of the parking lot on the two lots of the single zoning lot. The two tax lots are adjoining lots. One is 10,000 square feet, the other is 2,000 square feet. One lot with 100 feet of frontage on 227th Street and 120 feet of frontage on 145th Road. The lot is currently improved with a 27 foot wide curb cut on 145th Road and its surface is light duty asphalt paving. There's been a new drainage system installed with DOT permits and a 10 foot high forever green hedge chain link fence. The proposed development will make productive use of a site that's been neglected for many years. It will be a public parking lot with 25 parking spaces. It will use the existing curb cut and comply with all landscaping requirements. The use will be compatible with an existing commercial and manufacturing uses within a larger residential area. It will serve nearby retail stores within a commercial overlay and storage and office buildings in the nearby manufacturing district. In addition, it will relieve parking on the surrounding parking demand on the surrounding residential streets. The community has expressed its support. We have a letter from council member Jonathan Richards to use the City Planning Commission consideration, and Committee Board 13 voted unanimously in favor of this.
So just to put it on the record, how many spots is it?
25 is in our application.
And is it going to be public parking here or accessory parking?
Public.
And long term or short term?
Short term.
Short term parking, not to conflict with the Park Authority's goal of having long term parking in the site. Questions?
Yeah. So So the lot is currently in use as a parking lot?
The use is not authorized until we have our rezoning application approved. There weren't any violations issued for parking use. We appeared earlier this week on those hearings and we sent.
Is the lot being operated by the applicant or a parking entity?
It could be operated by us, the applicant. We're the owner of the adjoining properties.
And who do you expect to be parking here?
We expect, for the most part, the employees that work at the two adjoining facilities. If you'd like, I can show you the zoning map.
John, this is a principal.
This is the surrounding area. That's the subject property we're talking about today. This is a, these are air freight logistics facilities, right, serve JFK Airport. They all comply with our parking requirement, except that in operating these properties, and we built this property 2 years ago, we discovered that the parking is yet inadequate because of the number of people that work here. And so we want to keep those people off the street, and so they don't compete with the residential parking on the street. And we thought that we would acquire this property here, turn it into a parking lot, so that everyone working here would be off the street.
And would they be paying for the parking?
As far as I'm concerned, no. I just need to get my tenants and employees off the street.
Where's the 65 spots you have?
This property has a parking lot here. We own this parking lot here, which is a new parking lot that we built. These are parking lots here. And this side here has parking here.
I think that what Mr. Foy's getting to is how the public parking spots if they're going to be used for the employees.
Well, they can't be, I'll let Steve speak to that. If there's someone that needs to come here and park, and we have, it's like first come, first served.
So if they're not employees, they'll be charged for parking?
Pardon?
If they're not employees in these manufacturing buildings, they'll be charged for parking. There'll be a fee for parking.
Let me just address that. Originally, we were proposing to extend the M11 and make it an accessory parking. It was suggested by the Department of City Planning that a commercial overlay or public parking lot would better serve because it's not an extension of the M11 to the residential. So it allows the undermined residential to residential district to remain, and we have a C22 overlay, so therefore we had to create a public parking lot. Anybody that wants to come here or a neighbor or a resident can park here. We haven't established a fee structure yet at this point. Once we have our approval, we will do that. So, we expect that most of the employees of these two facilities will park here. If someone else wants to park here, they can. The whole point here is to take cars off the street. That's really what we're trying to do.
Understood. I just was wondering if it's a public parking lot and you have to get a consumer appearance license.
Absolutely. When we have our final CFO, we'll require a consumer affairs license. We'll have a booth. We'll have an attendant.
You have posted parking rates, okay?
Absolutely. Whatever the regulations require from DCA, we'll
require. Are your other parking spots manned as well?
No. They're not in one, so. Yes. No, I'm sorry. These are all fenced in and gated.
We have to show employee ID and parking lights.
Yes. We have a full-time superintendent that runs this building, and he knows where everybody goes.
Can you run a capacity?
Yes. We're fully leased. Just so you have a picture. Here we are. This is the new building that we built on this site. That was a 1919 industrial building that was a major disaster for the neighborhood that we demolished and built this building. And this is the existing two buildings here that we purchased in 2012 and totally renovated. And they all have their own parking, but in our experience, we need additional parking to get our employees off the street.
And
so now you're going to have someone there making sure they work there, charging them, figure out a way of.
We do.
Having a system set up to charge and all of that.
They have full-time security staff.
24/7.
They have a superintendent that works there. I mean, this is one of the most modern airframes, just these buildings.
And why didn't you just go for accessory parking?
Again, because...
It's true, city planning made the suggestion.
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
Not only, not city planning did make the suggestion, Chairperson Weisblatt made the suggestion that he would prefer to have a commercial overlay with a public parking facility than an extension of the M1. We said it doesn't, as long as we can get a parking facility there, we have no problem doing it.
Thank you.
I appreciate it, thank you very much. Is there anybody here to testify? No? Great, seeing no one else here to testify, the item is closed, thank you. The next meeting of the land use hearing, Borough President's land use hearing is June 2nd, 2016. I see no other speakers. This hearing is closed. Thank you.